It's me, Beata, from horoscopesandreadings.com, and in today's video I would like to focus on the eclipses. Maybe you already know that in July 2018 we will experience two important astrological events named eclipses. First, there will be the eclipse which will happen on 12th of July. This is called a partial solar eclipse, and you know, I would assume that this eclipse is less important in comparison to the other one. But first I would like to start with the first one, so you will get a flavor what you can expect. I would like to tell you that this video is general, so here I am talking about general influences what these eclipses can bring to us. If you want to know more how these eclipses will affect you personally, or if it will happen for you, you have to check with your astrologer, okay? Because this is video for many people, but we all are different. I would like to tell you that at least I would like to give you a hint. If you have any planets in Cancer, especially on 20 degrees on Cancer, you will feel the effect of this eclipse, because this first solar eclipse will happen on 20 degrees of Cancer, which is indeed the influence which will be felt the most. So if you know your birth chart, you can check it if you have this one, because if you do, you will feel eclipse very much, okay? Both eclipses, for both eclipses, I have to tell you that their effects are most potent few days before the exact date, and also few days after the exact date, okay? So this first eclipse will be potent on 12th of July, but of course we will feel the effect before and also after. How much you will be affected, it all depends on your birth chart, okay? So as I have said, first eclipse is let's say less stronger, or I would even say less dramatic for you or for all of us. This first eclipse we will experience, of course there will be Sun conjunct Moon in this eclipse, and it will be, you know, much smoother. So in general I have to say that this first eclipse will bring us things. This eclipse will also be about change, but this change will be rather smoother. And you know, if you had any goal you've been following lately, this can come to completion for you, and the results will be good. So this first eclipse is really much more beneficial. Of course there is change, but overall it will not be so dramatic, okay? Now when it comes to second eclipse, I personally consider the second eclipse let's say more important, because it will be total lunar eclipse, okay? So it's actually called blood moon. Maybe you have already heard about this blood moon, so you know what I'm talking about here. So when it comes to this second eclipse, here I would like to be more specific, more concrete, and in second part of the video I will go through, you know, each sign, so you can check your sun sign and your ascendant sign, because I will tell you exactly the area of your life which will be affected the most by this total lunar eclipse, okay? So this total lunar eclipse, aka blood moon, will take place on 27th of July 2018. What's very interesting about this, let's say a little big dramatic eclipse is that it will be visible by our own eyes. You know, not worldwide, but if you live in Europe, if you live in Australia, if you live in South Africa, if you live in Asia, you can definitely check this eclipse by your own eyes. That's why its effect will be very strong, okay? So this total lunar eclipse will happen on 4th degrees of Aquarius. So if you have any planets on this degree of zodiac sign of Aquarius, well then watch out for this lunar eclipse, okay? For instance, I don't have any, you know, planets here, so I would assume that this eclipse will not be so important for me personally, right? So I would not cancel my vacation because of this eclipse. But your case may be different, right? That's why you still have to go back to your birth chart and check what is written there for you, okay? So now I would like to continue. I would like to explain you why this second eclipse will be so important and also so intense, because that whole lunar eclipse will conjunct planet Mars. And if you know, Mars is still retrograde. So, you know, Mars itself is very, let's say, angry and action-oriented planet. But if you have Mars retrograde in the sky, in conjunction to this total lunar eclipse, some interesting but not always pleasant things can happen, okay? So first, what I would assume will take place is that there will be arousal of anger. So maybe you will feel more angry even a few days before that eclipse, because as I have said, eclipse is potent a few days before the exact date. So I would expect that there will be increased violence between people, because you have to understand that if Mars is retrograde, Mars don't like it, and that's why Mars behaves violently, and its effect is very strong, but not in a pleasant way, okay? That's why I would expect that there will be arousal of more primitive instincts of people. And you know, that's why we have to watch out for this one, okay? Because there is indeed, you know, purpose why this eclipse is happening like this, that there is that conjunction with Mars. And I have to say that for me, it seems like there is that strong need for change in people. But maybe you have already noticed that people don't like to change just by because they want to change. We people, we have to be forced to change, okay? So that's why these circumstances have to be more painful, right? And only then we can change and, you know, grow to our better selves. So so overall, this second eclipse will be intense, might be dramatic. There will be results or some results you will not like, but it all depends on the area affected for you personally. But at the end, it all leads to higher consciousness for you. So there is really that evolvement of consciousness for people. But yes, it is dramatic, it is intense, and sometimes you might feel like you are forced to do it by other circumstances, and you have found yourself in circumstances you don't like, or, you know, you didn't choose for you. But this is actually proposed of this second eclipse. Well, you know, during the year we experience eclipses. So this is not something like, you know, whole world will change for you, like some people say, but definitely you should pay attention to this eclipse if you have some planets in Aquarius, and specifically on the fourth degrees, that because you will be affected directly by that house where you have this bunch of planets in Aquarius, and also, you know, we can tell a lot more specifically for you. Now, in second part of the video, I will go from Aries to Pisces, and I will tell you, you know, just a little bit more where you will feel the effect.